In this video, I want to talk to you about opportunity, and specifically, I want to break it down into three distinct aspects of opportunity. First, opportunity generation, okay? That is the creation or bringing about of an opportunity for yourself. Second, recognition, that is the ability to recognize or identify the existence of the opportunity, which oftentimes that aspect of what is opportunity and how you create opportunities for yourself is widely overlooked. And then opportunity exploitation, what it means to take advantage of, all right, or benefit from the opportunity. Now, I want to look at this particularly in the aspect of career prospects, okay, career development for specifically business students, but really that could apply to almost anyone, but specifically in this context, business students. So with that being said, let's start with opportunity generation. And what does that mean, generating an opportunity? Okay, I tell my students all the time, if I were to ask you what you want to be in life, the greatest dream you could possibly have, what if, you know, no barriers there, just anything you want to be, what would you be? And people throw out things. Oftentimes I hear, you know, movie star, fashion designer, professional athlete, things like that, right? And what I find really interesting is generally whatever people want to be, they've done very little or have even known how to do very little in terms of how they would generate that opportunity for themselves, okay? Now, in terms of business careers, okay, we have a bit of a roadmap there before us many times for many career paths. Okay, some career paths are less obvious, right? To be in the movie industry, fashion industry, publishing, things like that, it's less understood by the public, right? It's a very guarded industry type thing, and there are a lot of inside secrets. You want to be in that industry, you kind of just have to get lucky and stumble your way in sometimes through, you know, taking whatever potential opportunity presents itself. But that being said, to the extent you are able to identify things that will prepare you, they generally fall into these categories. One, credentials. Oftentimes there's a credential necessary to create an opportunity. That is, you can't be a CPA without an accounting degree. Okay, so that's necessary. You can't be a lawyer without passing the bar exam. That type of thing. So credentials required oftentimes. If you want to work for a specific company and you know they're only hiring people in operations with a PMP certification, well, there you go. That's a credential that might be required. So that would be required to generate an opportunity for yourself. Subject matter knowledge. That is, oftentimes jobs require you to come in with a certain amount of understanding of what you're already doing. Now, that's not always the case. Many jobs employers anticipate the ability to train you on different aspects of what you'll be doing. Well, with that being said, there is, once again, certain level of understanding that is required, certain amount of concepts you should understand, theoretical knowledge, that type of thing. So acquiring the subject matter knowledge necessary. Oftentimes, employers will not hire someone for something that if they haven't seen that the individual has experience in that area. You'll see most job postings these days require 2 to 10 years experience, right? Which oftentimes is a little ridiculous because there's, you know, it's not likely that someone could have that many years of experience in a given area at a certain point in time in their career, particularly for the specific level of position that the company is hiring for. But that being said, to the extent you're able to generate the experience necessary for the job, once again, is a way of creating or generating an opportunity for yourself. And then the biggest one, connections and networking. People who are born with connections have a huge advantage over other people, okay? But it doesn't mean you can't do the work yourself and generate or create those connections. Because once again, the majority of people still are hired through referral, through people they know, that type of thing. So the people in your network, the people who can present you with opportunities, the people who can actually hire you in some situations, or the people who can connect you with others, give you a reference, help you understand career paths or industries, that type of thing, are extremely important. So in terms of credentials, right, business students, get your business degree, get your certifications, have a good GPA that may be required for like professional services firms like consulting and things like that. If you know you want to work for a certain type of firm and they only hire from a certain level of school, doing the work necessary to get into that school, go for a secondary degree, a master's degree or something like that type scenario. Get the certifications, a CFA, a CPA, whatever type of certification is necessary in your industry to create the opportunity. Subject matter knowledge, learn about the stuff. Yes, you have a degree in something, but you honestly acquire more subject matter knowledge through other methods or means sometimes. Sometimes it's reading material, textbooks, case studies, that type of thing. Other times it's taking part with hands-on projects, doing experiential learning, internships, that type of thing, right? Experience, right? First place to start experience is internships. If you can't get an internship, volunteer, right? If you can't get into the firm that you want to, get into a firm that you can get into and just start building towards the level of experience and exposure that is going to be necessary to qualify once again for what employers are looking for. And throughout this entire process, just doing that, when you're building the credentials, when you're building your subject matter knowledge, and when you're building your experience, network. Meet anyone in the field or industry who is relevant to that. Introduce yourself, endear yourself to them, show that you understand them, and make them understand you, right? We have lots of videos on networking specifically, and how you have these professional one-on-one conversations, what you can expect from networking, that type of thing. So watch those videos to help you understand that. But suffice it to say, the connections that you make are going to be so important, so instrumental. And through all of this, the knowledge that you acquire, right? Whether it's industry specific, career specific, job specific, skill based, or just general understanding, right, is going to help you recognize when an opportunity presents itself. Okay, lots of this comes down to the soft skills, your willingness to communicate with others, your willingness to start the conversation. It is statistically likely that you have at some point in time in your life, if not many points in times in your life, stood beside someone who you had no idea who they were, you never started a conversation, but you could have. And if you had, it would have changed the course of your life forever. Many of you can recall an incident of that already. You did start the conversation and it did change the course of your life immeasurably. Okay? So that being said, just suffice it to say that oftentimes the ability to recognize an opportunity requires the one foresight to look for it, right? To know what to look for, to know what could be an opportunity, right? And that comes once again through that whole stage of opportunity generation. The information knowledge you acquire will help you in recognizing what could potentially be an opportunity, and then just simply having the gumption to show up, right? Just that alone can make it so that the opportunity you created or generated presents itself to you. Now, the opportunity exploitation phase, that is taking the next step. The opportunity presents itself, it means applying for that job. It means trying to connect with that person who will refer you. It means doing the work. It means putting in the diligence, developing the work product, developing the credentials, things like that necessary for that opportunity to be what you think it could be, the thing that leads to a certain point in your career, the thing that leads to the job you're looking for, or that leads to promotion, or that leads to whatever goal or objective you have in terms of career development. Okay, but one of the most important things, and we talk about this extensively in other videos, is the idea of fit. That is, the idea that you fitting with others, you assimilating to their culture, you demonstrating a level of commonality of values, beliefs, and interests, right? Making the other person feel like they're understood and you feeling like you understand them, okay? And them feeling like they understand you, right? The back and forth of understanding and your ability to create this network for yourself is incredibly important in terms of one, taking advantage of an opportunity, having that introduction turn into a job, or having that job turn into a career path, or having it being a stepping stone to a better job, or whatever. It always results from your ability to interact with others and the connections that you make. I will say this, your ability to fit in well and your ability to network well and socialize well with others is more important in terms of career development and career promotion than even your work product, okay? So that being said, oftentimes your work product and your diligence will play into how well you fit and that type of thing, and will affect the extent to which you can network with others. But that being said, so I ask you once again to think about opportunity in terms of generation of the opportunity, recognition, and exploitation. Lay out a map, set out a plan, identify the things you need to do, identify, and ultimately the idea of recognition will develop itself, okay? You'll be aware. You'll always be on the lookout, and then you'll be ready. You'll be ready, okay? Once again, back to that scenario of what do people want to do in life? Given the opportunity to do exactly what they want to do in life, so many people would work tirelessly. They would be so diligent. They would put out their best work product they could, and they would do everything possible. Unfortunately, oftentimes, they never generate the opportunity, or they never recognize it once it's presented. So the ability to work diligently, to create good output, to ultimately do the things that would be necessary to be who you wish to be, never materializes. Don't get caught in that cycle. Don't make certain to work as hard on generation and recognition as you do preparing yourself or being ready to exploit an opportunity.